He didn't deserve to be treated like that. So I told him everything. About me and Hiroki in the game not being recognized. About my no trust displaying and the fear of being ridiculed by him. That's only partially true. I'm gonna keep my feelings and wishes to myself. I had a burning desire to see Hiroki again in the world of Shadowtime and to prove to myself good so he could pay attention to me. Hey, I don't know why you're so worried. You just begun playing, and you need to get in the game. I'm gonna make it. All I need is some time, but I'm not sure if I have it. You know I'll be there in case you need any help or advice. I know, and I thank you for that, Daisuke. Came into my gloomy and empty apartment and threw my books onto the floor. I took the letter out of my backpack and opened it. It read, "Dear Mrs. Okamoto, we're hereby sending you the last warning to pay off your debt. We give you a month's time starting from the day you receive this letter to pay the entire sum of your debt. Otherwise, you will be forced to leave your apartment, and all your possessions will be sold in order to cover your debt." What's this? Mom never mentioned we were in debt. Oh no, but how did all of this happen? Mom's been so busy, she probably forgot to pay the bills. I'll explain everything to Daisuke. I don't want him to think we're in trouble. Sorry, Maria. No, that must be a mistake. I hope you're right. And again, I felt like I had a raging cloud above my head, which would never dry out. I could have simply started the game and forgotten about reality. The reality of unpaid bills and irresponsible mother. I was still holding the phone in my hand, thinking whether I should call Mom or wait until she got back. Message from Daisuke. It says, "I'll help you, Maria." I replied quickly. I admit I'd like to know how he plans to help me. I suppose he wants to offer me money, but I can't accept that. One thing is for sure, I need to find a job as soon as possible to help my mom pay the bills. Soon after that, I received a message from Daisuke. I'll explain everything. See you at school. The next day, I arrived at school just before the beginning of the first class. In order to avoid Daisuke asking me about my mother's letter, I was feeling really so embarrassed. The last thing I needed was Daisuke letting me money again. And when at lunch break, there he was standing right in front of me. "Oh, there you are! I didn't see you!" "Listen, Maria." He was in a very good mood, which pleased me. Obviously, he was bringing some good news, and I didn't think for a second that they were related to me. "You must have some good news, am I right?" "I have great news. You like video games, and you're good at them, right?" "Well, yes, I think so. Why don't you use that to make some money? What do you say?" "I don't understand your point exactly. I want to hear what he has to say, because that's going to help me get the money I need. First, listen to me, and you'll see it's not that hard." "Okay, I'm all ears. There's an option of burning real money in the game. For example, certain quests or rare artifacts that you find Yes? We'll play together. You want us to play together? In a way, I can reveal you to the exact locations of rare artifacts and the shortest way to get them. But it has to be our little secret. Sounds interesting, but is it allowed? It might not be allowed, but all experienced players already know what I'm going to tell you. This will be just a little help for you. I get it now. So there's a chance some people already know all of that. Some experienced players perhaps do, but the new ones probably don't. That's why you'll have a head start, which is exactly what we need. Does everyone qualify for a quest that we feel money? There are certain limitations, but that's not an obstacle. All you have to do is reach level 5 as soon as you can. I knew it. I'll try. I spent the rest of the day avoiding Hiroki and thinking about that day still time. Finally, school's over for today. Hiroki was absent. I'm wondering if that has something to do with the game. Apart from Hiroki, I'm thinking about Dice's proposition too. I could definitely use Dice's help, but only in the case if it's necessary. I still have nothing to lose. I went past the game store again. Next to the poster of Shadowtime placed in the shopping cart, there was an invitation for all players to join special quests that bring real money. Above the poster, the timer was counted down 5:49, 5:48. That's what Dice was telling me about. I looked at the time and hurried up so I could get home faster. I have almost 6 hours left before they unlock the quests. I'll use that time to build and improve my character as much as possible for such a short time. But first, I must call Dice. Hello, Daisuke. I just went past the game store. I saw the poster. Me too. So have you decided? I'll try. With I'll be home soon and I'll log in as soon as I can. I'm counting on your help. Sure. I'll be there, Maria. Call me anytime. Thanks, Daisuke. I didn't have time to lose, so I started the game as soon as I came home. There's only one day left until Mom gets back from her trip, and I'm gonna use it to the fullest. Welcome back, Kazumahari. It seems I'm lucky here this time. There are no guards in front of the gate, so I quickly reached the ledge hidden behind the stone walls. A notification saying that was a non-combat zone was blinking on my visor all the time, and it meant I couldn't attack other players. Thanks to that, I myself was safe too. That was such a great relief. And then I swear, I think I can see a traitor, a blacksmith, fitting in. Where would I go first? The most logical place where I can find information about the new quest is definitely in.
Sometimes, when we're meditating and we realize the mind's wandered off, we might not...
I came into the inn and was instantly overwhelmed with the smell of tobacco and wine. A player with a dark elf avatar was laying on the floor, probably drunk. A midget from the next table was laughing out loud, and in the darkest part of the room, that's Hiroki! I was hoping to find him here. He didn't pay attention to the people coming in because he was occupied with the mug in his hands. Please, welcome. How can I help you? The owner of the your sister and if anything you can come out. I took a few steps and came closer to her. Thank you, sir. How can I help you? Anything to drink? I need some information. I was wondering if you could help me with that. Sure thing, but first, should I offer you a drink? Thanks, but then I'll owe you. This is on me. Okay, I owe what it feels like when we're up together. A quick tip, get yourself a weapon, any kind of weapon. I know that. I'll find a weapon, but first I need to get some money. Do you have any quests for me? You can find all the little quests on the next board. Be careful not to bite off more than you can chew. Good luck. Thank you. The notice board was hung on the wall near the table where Hiroki was sitting. I tried to look confident while I walked towards him. But Hiroki didn't even lift his head while I was passing by him. I'm wondering what it is that's bothering so much. I stood in front of the board and tried to find quests for the low-level players. Let's see what I could take. On the back side of the object. I bet your man, I need a favor. I'm desperate, my field are destroyed. Help me get rid of the wild boars that are destroying my crops. The reward will be more than generous. Have a safe journey, I believe in you. Fine, if the wild boars are destroying the lives of poor peasants, then I guess I'll have to fight them. Alright, guys, just a second.